thank you once again, Sayyid Haydar Jayzani, for that wonderful recitation of the dua that we should recite before sunrise. Inshallah, we can begin to implement these duas into our daily lives, and they can bring about so much goodness and blessings to us. Assalamu alaikum, dear viewers, and welcome once again to Hijab and Etiquette. Now, today we're going to be discussing the topic of more than just a headscarf. The problem that we face today with the hijab is that the hijab, it's just been limited to a simple scarf that we wear on our head, when actually it's a greater concept which encompasses the lives of not just sisters but brothers as well. So inshallah, today I will be discussing this topic with Sister Masuma Jaffa. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
How are you doing today?
Alhamdulillah, how about yourself?
Oh, I'm doing really well, alhamdulillah. I'm really excited about talking about this, actually. I mean, it's quite bizarre, really, how like a whole concept as complicated as hijab, we have just limited it to literally just like the scarf that we wear on our heads. Like, why do you think we've done that?
I think the scarf is the thing that is out of the norm, wearing it on your head. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why everyone seems to focus on the scarf rather than the actual clothing. And forget about the inner hijab, where, you know, it's like we're so focused on the physical clothing. Mm-hmm. And for those who choose to wear Western clothes, the scarf is the only thing that actually makes you stand out because you can wear baggy clothes, which is part of the physical hijab, and not stand out. It's the scarf, when you put on the scarf on your head, that makes you stand out a little bit. Mm-hmm. And I think that's why the emphasis has been on the headscarf. And the sad thing is, because the emphasis has been on the headscarf, a lot of young girls and even older people believe that hijab is covering your hair. So you'll see people outside who have their hair covered perfectly and they'll be wearing really tight clothes, really short clothes, you know, like short tops. And you're just like, no, that's not the hijab. Hijab is about covering your whole body so the shape of your body doesn't show. So it's not just about the hair, it's about the whole body. So again, you have two extremes. You have those who will wear the headscarf and not worry about covering their bodies completely. So maybe they'll wear t-shirts, or they'll wear, you know, sleeves rolled up, or tight clothes where, you know, their body shape showing. Or you'll have those who say, no, it's about modest dress and it's not about covering your head. And again, both are wrong. It's about, yes, it's about modest dressing, which is covering your body, so the shape of your body doesn't show. But it's specifically about covering your hair as well, because that is part of the beauty of a woman.
Yes, yes, it's the ultimate beauty of a woman. And yes, I know myself on a daily basis, like I see, you know, sisters who unfortunately, you know, they're not wearing the hijab to its fullest potential as such. Can you give me some examples of what you mean by like these sisters, you know, wearing the headscarf but like the rest of what they're wearing isn't appropriate as such?
So for example, I've seen, I mean, like a lot of the times when you see school children going to school, a lot of the girls will wear trousers, they'll wear the school uniform, so it'll be made up of trousers and a blouse or a jumper on top, and the jumper's up to their waist, so you can see the whole shape of their body, and then they'll have a headscarf on. Or, you know, in the summer they'll wear skirts, which, okay, you know, out of modesty will come below the knee, but then you can see the rest of their legs. So, you know, it's not just about covering your hair, it's about covering your whole body. The only thing that should be showing is your hands up to the wrist and your face. And that's it. And everything else should be covered. And covered in a way that the shape of your body doesn't show. So that's really, really important. So again, wearing skinny jeans is not covering.
No, it isn't, because you can see everything practically.
And I think, you know, it's sad because they say, I don't want to be told what to wear. But I'm sorry, what you're wearing is not what you want to wear. It's what you're being told by fashion to wear, by society to wear. So, okay, you're choosing not to be told by God, but you're choosing to be told by society. And you can see that, because whatever is in fashion, that's what everyone will wear. So it's not because they think this is what, they've come up with this amazing idea of what to wear, or they think this is what they want to wear. Because again, you can't tell me that 100%, you know, all those people who are following fashion actually think that this is what looks good and this is what they want to wear. They're wearing it because this is what the media is telling them is the next fashion.
Yeah.
I mean, if you were to talk to guys, you know, sort of 10 years before and say to them, you know, you'd be wearing really tight, skinny jeans, it's like they'd laugh at you because it was not the norm. They would, you know, and it looks so horrible. But that's what they do now because that's what media's dictated to them.
Yeah.
So, you know, either you're a slave of Allah or you're a slave of something else.
Mm.
I choose to be the slave of Allah.
Well, it's the better of the two options, isn't it? Absolutely. And I think you find, like, with these sisters, you know, who maybe they're a fan of the skinny jeans, like, you know, when they go to the mosque for Ramadan or Muharram or the wilayat of a shahadat of one of the masumeen, alayhim assalam, you know, they dress a lot differently, you know, and it's, I guess it's quite a sensitive thing, you know, talking to a sister about the hijab, because at the end of the day, like, it can come across as us criticizing the way that they're dressing, and it's a very personal thing, isn't it? So I suppose what's the best way to approach a sister about, you know, trying to encourage her to improve her hijab? Is this something that we should do, like, privately, or should we do it, like, out in open? Like, a classic example, you know, if a sister's maybe posted a picture on Instagram which isn't quite appropriate, should we put a comment for everyone to see saying, "Salam, sister, but, like, your hijab's totally wrong"? Like, how should we approach that?
I think first and foremost, it's important to build a relationship with a person so that they actually want to listen to you.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, no one likes to be criticised, whatever it's about.
No.
So to do it openly like that, I don't think they're going to listen.
Mm.
You need to come from a place of love.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you because I love you, not because I think I'm better than you, not because I'm holier than you, not because I know better. No, I'm coming, you know, if I'm doing something wrong, I would want someone to come and tell me because they loved me and they cared about me.
Mm.
And it's only because I care about you that I'm telling you. And I think it's really important to get that across. Mm. I remember, it reminds me of when I do these lectures at mosque, and there's a girl that comes to the lectures and proper hijab, fully, you know, like, amazing hijab, everything. And I was out shopping one day and I saw her, and she wasn't wearing hijab, no headscarf, no nothing, you know, it was just normal dress, normal clothes. And I was just so shocked because I assumed she wore hijab. And I saw her and I was like, oh my God. And it's like, and she said salam to me, and I'm one of these people who can't hide my reaction. It shows on my face. And I sort of said alaikum salam, and she could tell I was taken, and I was like, I'm really sorry. And I said, look, I'm really, really sorry. I'm not being rude or anything, but I honestly thought you wore hijab.
Mm.
And she sort of smiled and she didn't know what to say.
Mm.
And I said to her, look, let's go for a coffee. And she said to me, no, you know, I'm busy, you're busy. And I'm like, no, I want to go for a coffee. I don't want to go on my own. Why don't you join me? And we sat, and I bought her a coffee, and we sat and we talked about it. And I actually came from the perspective of, you know what, you're like a daughter to me. Mm. Just like I would tell my daughter, I'm telling you. I'm not even telling you, I'm asking you, what is it that I can do to help you on your journey in wearing the hijab? What is it that's stopping you? Just talk to me. I'm not going to judge you. I'm not going to, you know, and in the end, it's up to you where you want to take this. But I'm just letting you know, I'm here to help you in any way that I can.
Mm-hmm.
We sat there and we talked for a while. And, you know, at the end, when she got up to leave, I asked her if I could hug her. Aww. And she looked at me and she said to me, why? And I said, because I want you to feel the love that I feel for you.
Mm.
And I think that can only happen if I hug you, because I don't think you're understanding how much I love you at this moment.
Mm.
And it's, you know, and it's trying to get across from that perspective. And I truly did love her. And I really wanted to help her as my daughter.
Yeah.
As I wish, you know, if my daughter was doing something wrong, if I was doing something wrong, someone would help me because they cared enough about me to take time out in their day.
Mm-hmm. That's a really beautiful reminder. Like, wallah, we're just not affectionate enough with each other. Like, we really need to spread the love more,
for sure.
Definitely.
For sure.
And I guess just like, if we look at this situation from the other person's perspective, when a sister is being given advice from someone who's coming from a loving place, you know, I know myself, like in the early days when I started to wear hijab, my hijab was not correct. And whenever like someone pointed it out to me, even if they were doing it from a good place, like I would instantly get defensive. It was just like an ego thing within me, and just like I'd just be like, oh, you have no right to do that, like only God can judge me kind of thing, like, which is a bit of a daft statement really, because like that should scare you, the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ultimately the judge. But how should we as sisters respond to another sister giving us loving advice?
I think it comes from both. I mean, you mentioned your ego coming into play. I think also when I'm giving the advice, my ego may come into play. So if I'm giving the advice expecting her to take that advice, then I'm doing it from an ego perspective. If I'm giving her the advice knowing that that's what Allah would want me to do, and in the end Allah will guide, and it's up to her to take on that guidance if she chooses to, and that's not my journey, that's her journey. So not having my ego in place where now I feel bad because, you know what, I spent, I don't know, £3 on coffee for you, I spent an hour talking to you, and yet you're still walking out and you're not going to put on hijab. That's my ego coming into play as well. So it's realizing that the ego is in both perspectives, so it's from you and from me. And so taking a step back and saying, you know what, I'm here just to be there for you. I'm here to, you know, to sort of, maybe Allah chooses to use me as a tool to guide you, and I would welcome that. But in the end, it's your journey. You're the one who's got to answer to God. I've got to answer to God in how I guided you. And it's up to you. It's like, you know, when the Holy Prophet was told, you know, it's yours is only to tell them. Leave the rest up to God. And God will guide everyone. It's a matter of whether I choose to take that guidance or not. So I think, again, understanding that my journey is about getting closer to Allah, and you know, guidance comes from all different ways. So when I'm ready for that guidance, it's there.
Absolutely. It's amazing, like the Ahlul Bayt alayhim wassalam, like they're the perfect examples of this, because every day they would be advising people about how to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they never let arrogance take over, because what minute they would be giving advice to the people and the next minute they would be on their prayer rugs crying over not their sins but like what they thought that they were lacking in as such. You only have to hear some of the du'as from example Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, and you just, that humility that you can feel radiating from those words is just absolutely phenomenal. And I know myself, I remember the last time when a sister wanted to give me advice on hijab, like my first instinct was to kind of turn around and be like, mind your own business, love, you know, I'm covered, literally. But then I remembered the words of wisdom from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, when he said, the most beloved person to me is not the one who praises me, but the person who points out my faults to me. And it's just an incredible way of seeing things, like, wallah, these imams, they're just on a different level to us all together.
Sure. But I think also, again, I think you mentioned this, is hijab is a very personal thing. So again, realizing that each one of us is on a journey, and you know, we're on different places in the journey, and hopefully the journey is continuing, but I shouldn't expect your hijab to be like my hijab. I can explain to you why I wear what I wear, and you know, encourage you to sort of better your hijab. But again, if you feel you're comfortable with the hijab you are on, and again, it's a journey. You'll slowly, hopefully better it. And it's like when I look at my hijab when I was younger to when I was a little bit older to now, it's constantly changing. And it's sort of realizing that I'm the one who's got to answer to God for mm-hmm. my hijab, no one else. Mm-hmm. And I need to be comfortable with that. I need to be okay with telling God why I chose to dress the way I did.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it's not necessarily that if someone does it a different way, it's wrong. So for example, I'll give you a simple example. It's like I only wear black scarf, mm-hmm. a scarf on my head. I don't feel comfortable with any other color scarf.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't mean a color scarf is wrong.
Yeah.
My daughter-in-law, everyone that I know wears colored scarves, and that's fine.
Yeah.
But for me, I feel uncomfortable. I feel it's against my hijab, and that's a personal choice that I've made.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. You know, I would not push that on anyone else, because there's nowhere in Hadith that says you can't wear a colored scarf.
Yeah.
But again, it's a journey that I have taken, and where I'm deciding what's right for me. Because mm-hmm. I'm the one who's got to answer to God.
Yeah.
So that, again, like some people wear, decide that they have to wear the chador.
Mm.
And they feel uncomfortable with that. Again, that's their choice.
Mm.
And nowhere does it say you have to wear the chador. I can still cover myself without the chador if I choose to.
Yeah.
So it's different for different people. And understanding that it's a very personal journey.
Mm.
But realizing that it has to be a journey which doesn't stop.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
That's really, really important. And I think when someone then tells you, choose whether to take that advice or not, but question yourself whether your journey is still continuing or whether you've stopped.
Mm-hmm. That's fair enough, and your opinion is absolutely valid. And like, if you're not pushing it on others, then what's the harm of holding such an opinion?
Oh.
Yeah. Finally, sister, I would just I'd like to relate the physical hijab to the inner hijab, also known as the social hijab. Let's just say, you know, we've got the physical hijab ticked, like that's sorted. Like, how should our social and inner hijab be? How should we act with not only the opposite gender, but also non-Muslims as well?
I think it's important to look at the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduces the hijab in the Holy Quran. So he doesn't start off with the physical dress. Mm-hmm. First of all, he talks to the men before he talks to the women, which yes. is really, really
very
powerful.
Very important point.
Really powerful.
Yeah.
And he tells them to lower their gaze, and that's not lowering it and don't look at the women in at all. It's lower the intensity of your gaze. So mm-hmm. don't look at a woman with that sort of intense, lustful way.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people will turn around and say, well, you know what, in the West you're told that when you're talking to someone you should look at them in the face and talk to them. And again, Islam doesn't say you shouldn't.
Mm-hmm.
Islam says lower the intensity of that gaze. So mm-hmm. don't look at them in a lustful way.
Yeah.
Look at them with respect.
Mm-hmm.
And then it talks about, you know, covering your private parts. And then it turns to the women and talks about lowering the intensity of your gaze again for the women,
mm-hmm.
covering the physical hijab of covering your beauty mm-hmm. as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we concentrate on the physical hijab, but we don't concentrate on the social interaction. So the way that mm-hmm. we look at each other, the way that we interact with each other.
Mm. And in some ways, isn't that more important than the physical hijab in some ways? Yeah.
I think they both go hand in hand. I don't
Absolutely.
Think you can have both. I think the physical hijab is a barrier there to remind you and the other person that there is a barrier there.
Mm-hmm.
And then for me to then decide what that barrier should be when I'm interacting with you. And again, that should be dictated by God. So, you know, it's not that I can't interact with you, but there shouldn't be any unnecessary interaction. Mm-hmm. What is considered as unnecessary, again, very personal to me, myself, because I'm going to have to answer to God.
Mm-hmm.
Was that banter and joking unnecessary?
Mm.
Or was it something I felt I had to do for whatever reason?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely. Really thought-provoking conversation, and I thank you once again for joining me for Hijab and Etiquette. Next up, my dear viewers, your fiqh questions answered, inshallah.